In this video, I'll explain all the terms associated with the Cardano staking mechanism so you can maximize the returns on your stake. If you like this type of content, please make sure to like this video and to subscribe to the Nautilus Crypto YouTube channel. You can also support me by delegating to the Nautilus Crypto stake pool. This way, you can help me to create more videos like this and to drive adoption for Cardano. Just like Bitcoin, Cardano is a completely decentralized network, where transactions are validated by thousands of independent computers around the world, which in the Cardano network are called stake pools. With validation is meant that the computer grabs a bunch of transactions and basically checks two things: if the funds exist and if the funds are not double spent. Then the computer ties the transactions into a block and adds the block to the blockchain. Once a stake pool successfully added a block of transactions to the blockchain, the protocol creates new cryptocurrency, which is then used to reward the stake pool for supporting the network. This works similar to Bitcoin, where there's a maximum supply of 45 billion ADA that's ever going to be created, and the protocol gradually releases ADA into circulation as block rewards. Where the Cardano protocol differs from the Bitcoin protocol is that once a validator produces a block, not only the stake pool operator is rewarded, but all users that participate in the network are rewarded via a process called staking. In Cardano, this staking has two dimensions: pledge and stake. Pledge is the funds that the stake pool operator locked into its own stake pool. The stake is the funds that the ADA holders delegated to a stake pool. In contrast to pledging, with staking, funds are never locked, so they can be spent anytime. But how exactly does your stake help to secure the Cardano network? To answer this question, let's dive into how the staking mechanism works. In Cardano, the time is divided into epochs, and epochs are divided into slots, where an epoch is a period of 5 days, and a slot is a period of 1 second. Now, for each slot, the protocol selects a stake pool, which gets to validate the transactions in that time period. This selection procedure is done via a special kind of coin flipping protocol, which can be visualized as a game of spin the bottle, where the winner gets to validate the transactions in the next slot. Now, where the stake comes in is that pools with more stake delegated to them simply have a higher chance to get chosen to produce a block, and thus get to produce more blocks each epoch. Now, the pledge also has an influence on the amount of blocks a pool gets to make. This is a security measure, because if the pledge were to have no influence, this would mean it would be very easy for an attacker to spin up a lot of pools with no money in them, and get to control over 51% of the block production in the network, which is called a Sybil attack. The effect that the pledge has on the amount of blocks that the stake pool gets to produce is parametrically determined in the protocol by the A0 parameter. By increasing the A0 parameter, pools with little pledge in them get to produce less blocks in the network, thereby reducing the risk on a Sybil attack. Alright, so now we know how your stake helps to validate transactions in the network. Now, when the epoch comes to an end, rewards are calculated proportional to the amount of blocks each pool produced. One epoch later, rewards are paid out to the stake pool and its delegates. The rewards are distributed as follows. The first thing that happens is that the cut goes to the treasury, which is set by the treasury rate, which is currently set at 20%. Then, the stake pool operator charges a fixed fee, which is meant for covering for the monthly operating cost of the server. The fixed fee is a minimum amount which is set by the protocol, which is currently set at 340 ADA. Then, the stake pool operator charges a variable fee, which is meant to make stake pool operation more profitable than staking. This variable fee is set by the stake pool operator, which is usually between 1 and 5%. The remaining rewards are distributed to the delegators of the pool proportional to their stake in the stake pool. The rewards are automatically added to the delegator stake for next epoch, providing for cumulative growth of the funds over time. Now, if you want to choose a stake pool, it's important to note that stake pools with more stake delegated to them will give slightly higher ROI. This mechanism will motivate delegators to delegate to the big pools in order to maximize their profits. But how, actually, does the protocol prevent stake pools from becoming too big and get too much control over the network? To tackle this problem, the engineers at IOG introduced the concept of a saturation point. This mechanism basically slashes pool rewards for pools that grow bigger than the saturation point. By this mechanism, the protocol motivates users to distribute their stake to unsaturated pools, keeping the system decentralized. This is just an amazing innovation, as the amount of decentralization can now simply be controlled by adjusting the saturation point. The saturation point is determined in a mathematical formula where the saturation point is equal to the total amount of ADA into circulation divided over the amount of desired pools, also called the K parameter. So now we know how the staking mechanism works. But how do we now choose which stake pool to delegate to? So now we know that when we stake to a stake pool with more stake and pledge in it, we will get slightly higher returns. However, this is not the only thing one should take into consideration when choosing which stake pool to delegate to. Because one should also look at the choice holistically and look what value the pool provides to the ecosystem. Because some pools have a mission behind them, like for instance what I am doing with my stake pool. And by delegating to my stake pool, you support me in my mission, which is to add value to the Cardano ecosystem by creating easy to understand animated content. So if you found any value in this video and you want to support me, delegate to the Nautilus Crypto stake pool and earn rewards for doing so. Let me know in the comments down below if you delegated to the stake pool.